So initially, I think me, along with a lot of my teammates, our initial reaction to the game was obviously disappointment. We never want to come out and lose, especially in a conference game. But it's like our coach says, my position coach, Coach Ronnie V, it's never as bad as it seems, never as good as it seems, and somewhere in the middle reality falls. And so we got a chance to look over the film, me and the starting of the line. And we found the bright spots. We found some things we can be happy with, and we obviously found some things that we can get better at. So I think we'll work to try to work on our deficiencies and see if we can be better coming out this next week.
What were those things that you are happy with and that you want to change?
I think the thing I am happy with is that we all kind of played collectively, especially in the first half. We played with a really good flow, and we were communicating really well. One of the things that I think we need to be more aware of is that when blitzes come off the edge, especially with these weird fronts, we got to be mindful of, and it kind of goes back to what Coach Baylor said about doing our 1-11th, is that trying to control our one piece of the puzzle. We had some plays where we tried to do more than one thing, and they bring, you know, more than one guy. You can't block two guys with one person, so that's where we found some of our challenges.
How much of that is the trust issue that Coach was referring to, as far as like how much room do you guys have to improve to get that ultimate team togetherness on field?
I'd say less trust with us, because I think we have a really good trust all across the team. I think we all, especially even coming off of a loss like this, we still believe in each other. We still believe in the coaching staff. None of that is at fault, I think, right now. I think the biggest thing right now is the trust in ourselves that in doing our 1-11, that everything else will fall into place. I think sometimes you get caught up in the game and you think if you do more than your 1-11, that somehow it'll make up for somebody else not doing the 1-11. That doesn't work like that. You have to have a team effort.
Coach mentioned that some little things have to be fixed. Are little things easy to fix, or are sometimes they more difficult than you might think?
Little things are easy to fix in what they are to fix. Now, the difficulty is going to be being consistent, and consistency is being better than greatness is not easy to achieve. But it's the good thing is that it's small things to fix. We just got to continue to work at them. So I know we're gonna grind it out in practice this week and spend a lot of time on getting the very basics of how we play now. I think if we can consistently do that throughout the week and the rest of this year, you're gonna see a team that wins out and goes to conference championship.
How much does going through last year and seeing what you were able to do when you were 2-3 moving forward help the team this year, seeing that they're in the same situation?
And I feel like I have a unique response to this because I was a redshirt last year and I got to witness a lot of this. I wasn't in the mix of it as much, but I saw a team that, you know, we were in the same spot being 2-3, and I saw a team just come together in a strange way. It was they were already brothers. But it seemed like, especially in the locker room, there was so much more of a coalesced want and need to be great and to show people that Rice was better as a football team than what people thought. And I think starting off rough last year, especially with Notre Dame and A&M, playing those big games and getting to see where we needed to be better, I think it really did help for the rest of the year, making us a better football team and taking us to a good Hawaii Bowl win.
What have you seen change in Dreyfus?
I would say, I didn't really have a personal connection with him last year on the field because I wasn't playing, but Dreyfus seems to be more mature. He seems to be a better leader than he was last year in him being older. I think that it is like Coach Baylor said, he does try to do more, especially now that he's older and feels more responsibility to take more action when he's on the field. But I know that, especially we as an offensive line, we believe in our quarterback, and we know that as long as Dreyfus can not get flustered in trying to do more than he has to, and if we can take as much pressure off him as we can, then he's going to settle in. He's going to be a great quarterback, just like he was last year.
Anything else? Preston?